Hello viewers, this is Dr. Kishore. Today I'm going to deal with the Obola hypothesis. So this Obola hypothesis, which is a very beautiful phenomena, which is explained by this by the crick, the Watsonian crick. So where only the crick has explained about this Obola hypothesis, and you should be important to remember this Obola hypothesis, which can explain about the redundancy of the genetic code. That is very important to understand what is Obola hypothesis and what are the advantages, the significances which is associated with this Obola hypothesis. Right, let's start the class. Right, as we all know, the genetic information has to be flow from a DNA to the protein, right? This is the genetic information which is flowing from DNA to protein will having in various stages. That particular thing we will call it as the central dogma of molecular biology, right? You can see this, the DNA, that whatever information which is having in the DNA in a form of genes, that has to be given in a RNA. The process we will call transcription, right? So this transcription is nothing but a giving a information of the genes which are present in DNA to the RNA. But here you can see the important point is definitely here the RNA and DNA, this is to be uncomplementary. Complementary mean the sequence is exactly the natural unusual base pairing, right? So, and the information which is given in RNA, it has to be finally leads to the synthesis of protein, right? This process we will call translation. So here the translation, you can see the information which is coding to the synthesis of protein, we call it as peptide, right? This is what the flow of genetic information which can be taking place from DNA to the protein. So during this transfer of genetic information, definitely there is a unique code that can be present. That unique code which will comes here, we will call it as genetic code, right? Genetic code is a very unique code that will play an important role to reading of the message which is present in RNA. So according to that, it can try to bring the amino acids so that it can be ensuring that the synthesis of correct protein. So if that is to be correct, definitely which can be an active and functional protein that are important for the any kind of the cell. So we should understand here. So what do you mean by code? What do you mean by codon? This we should understand, because anyway, if you want a more clarification, what is genetic code and what is codon, you just go back to my previous video where I can explain about the codons and triplet codes, everything, and even properties also. You just go back to the genetic code video, and I'll try to keep the link in this particular video also, right? So here the DNA should consist of triplet bases. You should see here, these are the triplet bases. These triplet bases, nothing but three bases. So these three bases, we will call it as one codon. So one codon will code for one amino acid, clear? So three bases, we will call it as one codon. So one codon will code for one amino acid. So this codon is always complementary to the anticodon, right? This is, when you see this is to be complementary, and a few codons specify the instructions during the protein synthesis. That is nothing but whatever the codons which are present in the RNA, that all are not involved in the identification of amino acids. But only a few of them involved for this, we call it as start and stop codons, right? That anyway, which I'm try to discuss in a coming translational procedure. And you can see in a general important view, the codon will be written in 5' to 3' direction only. This is very important, students, right? If you take the gene sequences, we always write it in 5' to 3'. If you take it in a protein sequence, that always we will write into N-terminal to C-terminal. That is N to C. This is a fundamental rule you have to be remember in a molecular biology. Clear? Then, if you get an idea that are if you are having a confusion, little confusion, many of even the students they will get definitely the confusion where is anticodon is present, where is codon is present, and what exactly this is, right? Before explaining about actual the Vogel hypothesis, here I am trying to explain about the codon and anticodons, right? For suppose this is the mRNA, right? This is mRNA, this is the sequence. This sequence we generally call it as codon, right? These are all are codons, are codon. Clear? Right. So how does this codon will come? Because that is from the during transcription process, the DNA information which is given to this mRNA, the mRNA information we will call it as codon, right? So this is an information which is having an mRNA, and there is an RNA, one more RNA we will call it as transfer RNA. This is tRNA. tRNA should have a various kinds of various kind of its structural motifs that can be present. We'll call it as D loop, anticodon loop, T loop, and amino acid attachment sites, right? These are different regions that are present in tRNA three-dimensional structure, all right? Here, one important thing, anyway, I'm not going to explain about the structure of tRNA, but our concern is here, the anticodon loop. So the anticodon loop, which is present in tRNA, so you should be remember that anticodon is also be present on tRNA, right? Wherever we will get the anticodon loop, that is nothing but the anticodon is present on tRNA. So exactly, this is anticodon. This anticodon that can be present in tRNA, this is complementary to the codon. So codon, anticodon sequence will always to be complementary to each other. That is very important, we should understand. All right? So, and one more important thing here, why this tRNA is, we will call it as, this can have the unusual base pairs. So, because if you closely observe the structure of tRNA, definitely the structure of tRNA should have the unusual base pairs or unusual bases. One thing we will call inosine, second one is pseudouridine, and third one is tyrosine. So these are unusual bases that can only exist in a tRNA, not in any other kind of RNAs. So what does it mean? Because of these unusual bases that can present in a tRNA, will make tRNA to be and having a different property with the recognition of codon. Clear? That you should understand. So coming to the actual, that's all related with the introduction of the genetic code. Now actually coming to the hypothesis, that is Vogel hypothesis. So as I explained, this was given by the Crick in 1966 according to this hypothesis. So the first two bases of codon pair accordingly to the SAR. So this we generally call it as first two base pairs of the codon will have the normal base pairing with the last two bases of anticodon. This is very important. So here many people will get a confusion that, so this is the direction we have to be remember. So if we are saying in a same 5 prime to 3 prime direction of mRNA, even 5 prime to 3 prime direction of tRNA, then we will call it as first two bases of codon that are present in mRNA will be having a normal pairing with the last two bases of tRNA, if it is to be 5 prime to 3 prime orientation, all right? You should remember that, at the third base of the codon and the first base of anticodon, this is to be somewhat different. So where exactly the instead of normal base pairing, there will be unusual base pairing that can be present. So we will call it as that particular place is obling, all right? Obling is nothing but which is like a degeneracy. So the degeneracy which is associated in the third base of the mRNA and first base of the tRNA, right? Here you can more closely understand, right? You can see here, this is tRNA, as I explained in a previous structure. This is mRNA, right? So always we are writing 5 prime to 3 prime. You can see here, this is 5 prime to 3 prime direction. This is nothing but we are going in this direction, and this is also be the same direction, 5 prime to 3 prime direction. So you can see here the codon 1, 2 will have the same, as I explained, will have the same normal base pairing with the 3 and 2. This you should remember. The codon first code will pair with the third base of the anticodon, and second is second, right? This is to be a normal base pairing, and there will be a different base pairing, unusual base pairing, or degeneracy base pairing that can existing in the third code of the mRNA and first code of the anticodon, right? This particular position, 3-1 position, we will call it as oval position. Clear? So this position, we will call it as an oval position. And if you want to see it is in an elaborative manner, you can understand here at what basis this obling or this degeneracy can be taking place. So for suppose you take in a tRNA, this is all related with the first codon of tRNA, right? So if it is C, definitely it can be a normal that can pair with the G, and A, it can pair with the U. This is as usual normal. If it is G, that can be present at the first position of tRNA, it can recognize with the two complementary codes, that is C, U. And if you take the uracil, it can also be recognized too, that is A, G. And at the first position of anticodon, if it is the inosine that can be present, this is important, the inosine, it can recognize the three different codes of third position of mRNA, that is C, A, U. Clear? So this single, so what does it mean exactly? The meaning is very simple. The first two initial base pairing of initial codons, first two codons are very important for the recognition of amino acid. And third one will be on, that is choice based, which is not to be compulsory, but they, where the interaction will be on temporary interactions. That is not exactly taking care for the consideration for the identification of amino acid, right? Even you can also see in the same manner. So if mRNA at the third position, you can see if the uracil is present, this can be identified by these three, A, G, I, right? So these things anyway, you should be remember that. So always with respect to the directions, these directions are very important, right? These directions are very important. If you remember these directions only, you can understand very well about this oval hypothesis. Clear? Right? So again, I am explaining at the third base of the code to the first codon of first anticodon of tRNA, that particular place will be formed the oval hypothesis. That is the basic for the oval hypothesis. This we should understand. Clear? But then, is there any significance that are associated with this oval hypothesis? This is also be important. So there are a few significance that are associated as for the this hypothesis, which is states. So the multiple codes for a given amino acid that can be possible, that we will call it as degeneracy. This you can better understand that the genetic code. My last video on genetic code, because the degeneracy means here one code will code for one amino acid, but these multiple codons will code for only code for the same amino acid. This is degeneracy. That's what it should require 64. So out of 64, you just take three codons that are code for stop codons, and 61 codons will code only for the 20 amino acid. That can be possible because of this oval hypothesis. And second important point is the suppression of point mutation in the third base of the codon. This is very important. So if there is a change in the codon third position, definitely that will not to be effect that will not to be affect this pairing of anticodon, and which will not to have any kind of the clinical significance. That is very important, the second one. And third one is easily removed deacetylated tRNA during protein synthesis. So what do you mean by deacetylation? That the entire procedure I will discuss in the translational mechanism, that is called protein synthesis mechanism. But here you should remember that this is deacetylated tRNA. The removing of deacetylated tRNA, where exactly the oval position will be important for this process. And the important last significance, which is related with this, fewer tRNA molecules than expected. This is very important. Because if you take in a eukaryotes, right, the eukaryotic will have the 20 amino acid. 20 amino acid will having 61 codons. So if you take the tRNA, the main function of the tRNA is to be identification of amino acid. So there are 20 amino acids that are present. So the cell has to have the 20 tRNAs. But exactly this is not true. There are not 20 tRNAs that can be present in the cell. So which can tell you about this, the one or two amino acid will be identified by the same tRNA. That can be possible because of this OBUL hypothesis. This can also be, you should be understand about the importance of OBUL hypothesis. Anyway, this I am going to discuss in detail during the protein synthesis lecture. Right, friends? This is all related with this OBUL hypothesis. And see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.